چودھویں کا چاند ہو یا آفتاب ہو، جو بھی ہو تم خدا کی قسم لاجواب ہو۔
کے سوا دنیا میں رکھا کیا ہے؟
Too good. Well, I'm not surprised that this got viral. Tell me how it happened.
Actually, I made this video for a WhatsApp group. They asked me to make this video and send it to them on Rafi Saab's death anniversary. So I made this video and sent it to them. And after 2 to 3 weeks, they told me that it got viral on WhatsApp. I was like so surprised. Then after 2 days, I came to know that Anand Mahindra sir retweeted my Judish sir's post. Then it got viral. Yeah. I was like, oh my God.
And also Mr. Shankar Mahadevan and many more people.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. So like, I admire him a lot and his works.
So how does it feel when as a singer you're compared with Mohammed Rafi Saab?
It's like my heart skipped a beat. But you know, I'm nothing in front of Mohammed Rafi Saab. He's a unique person with both unique character and his talents, and I'm nothing in front of him. I'm just doing my justice to his song.
So which of the Rafi Saab songs do you like the most?
Ehsaan tera ho ja mujh par dil chahta hai wo kehne do mujhe tumse mohabbat ho gayi hai mujhe پلکوں کی چھاؤں
میں۔ Who introduced you to this music?
It's actually a famous Malayalam director called Johnson Master. He told me to concentrate on Mohammed Rafi Saab because I participated on a reality show, Malayalam reality show called Gandhara Sangeetam. So in that I have sung Suhani Raat Dhal Chuki. After that, Johnson Master told me that only concentrate on Mohammed Rafi song, nobody else.
So let's listen to that one.
Suhani raat dhal chuki, na jaane tum kab aaoge. Suhani raat dhal chuki, na jaane tum kab aaoge.
Kind of unbelievable for me, the way you change all the tones. I mean, but every different song, because every different song is it requires a different kind of feeling, different kind of, you know, and that magic that Rafi Saab brought. But tell me, as a singer, how does it feel? Yes. I mean, does it ever bother you that every time you're compared with Mohammed Rafi Saab, which is a great thing, but sometimes a singer also wants to be identified for his own texture, for his own style. Does it ever bother you?
I actually, you know, I don't imitate Mohammed Rafi Saab. I sing with my natural tone. So I think I'm pretty happy with it because all are accepting me. So they are saying that I have like small resemblance to Mohammed Rafi Saab. So I'm too happy to hear that, but to make one thing sure, that I'm nothing in front of Mohammed Rafi Saab. He's like a god to us.
You are a medicine student.
Yeah.
You're going to be a doctor. So tell me a little bit about that and what you chose that as, you know, your professional choice. And is singing ever going to be your professional choice?
And I idealized my grandfather a lot because he is a singer and a doctor too. I'm admiring his work. So I'm following his footsteps, you know. He introduced me to the music. So I hope I'll be not just like him. I'll be close, almost close to him, I guess. He's so great.
There's so many Mohammed Rafi songs that people must be requesting you to sing. Which one is your personal favorite?
Abhi na jao chhod kar کہ دل ابھی بھرا نہیں ابھی نہ جاؤ چھوڑ کر کہ دل ابھی بھرا نہیں ابھی ابھی تو آئی ہو ابھی ابھی تو ابھی ابھی تو آئی ہو بہار بن کے جائی ہو ہوا ذرا مہک تو لے نظر ذرا مہک تو لے یہ شام ڈھل تو لے ذرا.
How much of these songs do you really understand what you're singing? Is it just the words that you're playing with, or your understanding?
I actually you know sing by picturing that movie scenarios. I will picture in this particular song, I will picture Devanand sir and his girlfriend, they're talking to each other. I'll picturize them, and yeah, I guess I know some meaning, you know, some part of it, part of that music I know, but not all of it. I need to learn Hindi as soon as possible.
That'll be great. tell me, what about your friends, the classmates, or you know, people your age? How do they take it? Because you know, with the generation that belong to, many times people
music. My Chinese friends, they helped me a lot. Especially they taught me like how to sing and at which tone, like chest voice, head voice, mixed voice. They taught me everything. I'm like blessed to be in China too, because I've got lots of beautiful Chinese friends. They helped me a lot in music, and also my friends. I have got huge support from them.
What about China? Tell me about your connection with China. Are you studying in China?
I collaborate with them a lot. Their Chinese instruments. They taught me their Chinese. They taught me guitar, piano, everything. So
what? It's an online collaboration or something?
No. I've been in China for 4 years.
Oh, okay. And what for?
I'm pursuing MBBS in China. So.
Oh, you're studying there in China.
Yeah.
Right now, you're in India because of COVID situation.
Due to Corona pandemic, I came back.
Okay. So I've also got to know that it's not just the Hindi songs that you sing, not just the Bollywood song. Yeah. There is the variety. So tell us more about that. What else do you enjoy singing?
I love Elvis Presley and Jim Reeves, mm-hmm. Kenny Roger. I love them all, especially old country songs. And I'm actually a huge fan of Jim Reeves, I guess. His voice, vocal texture, and like he's got a manly voice. He make me fall in love with him. I don't know why. His song is that much mesmerizing. Wise men say only fools run. But I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be.
What are the future plans? I mean, of course, you're going to be a doctor.
I can't predict the future. So everything is left to God Almighty. And everything is left to all these people who are accepting me.
Before we end this interview, can we have one more beautiful song?
مستی ہے جس میں پیار کی تم وہ شراب ہو چودویں کا چار.